Welcome back. This is the rap sheet. Biden fooled y'all all. He's the real racist. Check this out.
Joe Biden recently signed off on Juneteenth as a national holiday in the U.S. The recognition of the holiday, which commemorates the end of slavery in the U.S., has been celebrated as a major symbolic shift away from the rhetoric of the Trump era. But many have forgotten this moment during the 2019 Democratic primary.
And I'm going to now direct this at Vice President Biden. I do not believe you are a racist. And I agree with you when you commit yourself to the importance of finding common ground. But I also believe, and it's personal, and it was hurtful to hear you talk about the reputations of two United States senators who built their reputations and career on the segregation of race in this country. And it was not only that, but you also worked with them to oppose busing. And, you know, there was a little girl in California who was part of the second class to integrate her public schools. And she was bused to school every day. And that little girl was me.
Despite insisting that she wasn't calling Biden racist, Harris was in fact accusing him of preventing black students from integrating into white schools and of being friends with openly racist politicians. So, what is Joe Biden's real record on race? Harris wasn't inaccurate in her criticism of Biden, who has a checkered history on racial justice, despite painting himself as a staunch civil rights advocate over the years. Perhaps one of the most criticized moments in Biden's past is his involvement in the creation of the notorious 1994 crime bill. People forget that the informal name for the bill was Biden's crime law. The legislation is widely criticized for being responsible for making the effects of mass incarceration in the US exponentially worse. Biden was also a key architect of the devastating Iraq War. Responsibility for the war is often blamed on George W. Bush, Dick Cheney, and other Republicans. But in reality, Biden played a key role as a Democrat. In the lead-up to the war, Biden convened a series of Senate hearings to drum up support for the invasion on the basis of flimsy intelligence material being presented by the Republicans.
What is the threat from Iraq? Obviously, to fully answer this question will require us to have additional and closed hearings.
Not a single anti-war voice was invited to the hearings. Biden also admits to having been civil with Democratic colleagues who were openly racist, like James Eastland, who had a long history of racist remarks, including that black Americans belonged to an inferior race, as well as the segregationist Herman Talmadge, who vigorously opposed school integration.
Governor, this means in effect that your state would set up a private school system.
We intend to maintain separate schools in Georgia, one way or another, come what may.
Biden also developed a decades-long friendship with segregationist Strom Thurmond, who he worked with attempting to pass the Biden-Thurmond Violent Crime Control Act in 1991. Biden also spoke at his funeral.
We became good friends. I'm not sure exactly why or how it happened, Nancy, but you know we did.
In the lead-up to the 2008 election, Biden was also in the spotlight for a number of comments, including referring to Barack Obama as articulate and clean, and associating Indian immigrants with Dunkin' Donuts and 7-Eleven chains.
Do these gaffes or misunderstandings or however you would characterize them indicate you're uncomfortable talking about race, or are people just being too sensitive?
I think that I have my whole career. I got involved in public policy. I got involved in politics because of the civil rights movement.
Biden also has an unreliable history surrounding his own involvement in the civil rights struggle. He has at times claimed to have been deeply involved. At other times, not that active, and in the lead-up to the 2020 election, once again claimed to have been heavily involved. He was also caught out claiming to have been arrested trying to visit Nelson Mandela.
This day, 30 years ago, Nelson Mandela walked out of prison and entered into discussions about apartheid. I had the great honor of meeting him. I had the great honor of being arrested with our UN ambassador on the streets of Soweto trying to get to see him on Robben Island.
You now say you weren't arrested and it didn't happen in Soweto. You were at the airport in Johannesburg and you were stopped from going through the door for blacks. I guess the question is, were you confused or were you just trying to embellish a story?
Offered the chance to run with Biden in 2020, Kamala Harris's once scathing criticisms about race faded away, and the two have worked closely since winning the election.
I believe you that you're fully supportive of him. How does that transition happen? How do you go from being such a passionate opponent on such bedrock principles for you, and now you guys seem to be pals?
It was a debate.
Not everybody landed punches like you did, though.
It was a debate.
So you don't mean it?
It was a debate. That the whole reason, literally, it was a debate. It was called a debate.
I understand.
Everyone traveled to the debate. There were journalists there covering the debate, where there would be a debate of differences of opinion and issues. Okay. I am 1,000% supportive of Joe Biden, and I will again do everything I can to make sure he is elected.
The Democrats may be keen to forget Biden's past, but should everyone else have to as well?